Hi, and welcome to Living Well Nutrition. I want to talk to you today about inflammation, and we're going to talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly. And inflammation is kind of a hot topic right now. And I want to tell you a little bit about the disease connection when we talk about inflammation. First of all, inflammation is not necessarily a bad thing. In fact, inflammation can be really good. If you sprain your ankle, you want there to be inflammation. That's the healing process at work. If you get food poisoning, you want the healing process to work. So the only time inflammation gets bad, or when it is bad, is when it becomes chronic inflammation, and inflammation lasts for weeks or months or even years. That's an inflammatory system that's gone awry, and that's where we have a problem. In fact, the inflammation that continues and it hangs out and it becomes chronic, that's the inflammation that can lead to diseases. And it can lead to a lot of diseases. In fact, the biggest diseases that plague our country are cancer, heart disease, diabetes. All three of those have a connection with it, chronic inflammation. But those aren't the only ones. Also, Alzheimer's has a connection with chronic inflammation. Rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, and IBS. These are things that have an inflammation as a kind of a founding component of the disease process. Migraine headaches also have a component of chronic inflammation. Even Hashimoto's, which is the most common autoimmune disease that faces our country. In fact, 1 in 4 adults have a chronic disease, and many of those are connected with chronic inflammation. So it's really important for us to figure out what we have going on with inflammation and how we can reverse that inflammatory process. So typically what we think about with inflammation, and we may not realize this, the common people may not realize this, but a lot of the inflammation starts right here in the gut. And let me explain to you kind of how that happens. When the gut gets irritated for whatever reason, and we can, the gut can start to get irritated by an illness, a virus. It can be irritated due to stress. It can be irritated due to diet, a bad diet. So if you eat the standard American diet, or you eat a diet that's high in sugar, a lot of fast foods, processed foods, a lot of times that's gonna be very irritating to the gut. Now the epithelial cells that line the gut are only about a one cell deep. So it's very easy to irritate that. And the immune system responds with acute inflammation. And that's a proper response in the gut at that time. However, because we continue to eat fast foods, we continue to eat foods that are high in sugar, we continue a very stressful lifestyle, and we're not managing stress appropriately, we can end up with chronic inflammation in the gut. Now, the gut has very, what we call tight junctions or desmosomes, and that prevents food that hasn't been fully broken down and digested from getting through. When there's inflammation and the gut lining is irritated, these tight junctions, these desmosomes, become loose, and food particles that are not yet fully digested, not fully broken down, can get through these junctions. And so rather than, let's say, a single cell or a single particle getting through, we actually have groups. So instead of an amino acid, we have polypeptides getting through those tight junctions. When that happens and they get into the bloodstream, the immune system picks up on that and says, whoa, you're not supposed to be here. I don't know what you are. I don't recognize you. And he calls on the immune system to attack. So you might start reacting to foods that are normal, healthy, normal foods, but you're reacting because they're not fully broken down. They're not fully digested before they're assimilated. Once that immune system has been triggered and you continue to eat and the immune system continues to see these foreign invaders, it will just continue to amp up its immune response, and you have an elevated immune response that lasts days and weeks, months, years possibly. And the immune system starts to target that foreign invader, and then it goes on the offensive and looks for anything that looks like that foreign invader anywhere in your body. That could mean the thyroid tissue actually looks a lot like the protein in wheat, and it's a protein called gliadin that's in the gluten molecule. And so if you've been responding, if your gut's inflamed and you've got some of that protein from the gluten that's coming into your system and the body's reacting to that, it might mistake the tissue in the thyroid as that foreign invader and could be the starting point for Hashimoto's, which is why if you have a thyroid condition, if you have Hashimoto's or Graves' disease, typically an informed practitioner will say you need to stop eating wheat completely now and possibly forever. If you have an autoimmune, you need to do that. So it can also start to affect other parts of the body. Joints are another popular place that the body will start to attack, and you'll start to get sore joints and maybe arthritis. So the inflammation that can begin here due to stress, feeling, you know, kind of holding the stress in, or from that unhealthy diet or from an illness, and it can also start because of aging. As we age, our body starts to produce less digestive enzymes, specifically less hydrochloric acid. That starts to drop at about the age of 40, at about 1% a year for normal people. Some people it's going to drop faster, some people it's going to drop before they hit 40. And it makes it harder for your body to break down and digest proteins, animal proteins. And those can start to irritate the digestive tract as well. So it's very important that we take really good care of our digestive tract so that we don't have inflammation here that then becomes systemic and runs throughout the rest of the body. Well, thanks so much for joining me today. I hope that you'll be able to come back next time and hear more about inflammation and the disease connection. We're going to be talking a little bit more in depth about cancer, heart disease, and diabetes. Till next time.